Hello everybody and welcome to a brand new tutorial series on the Golang programming language. Now this is also referred to as Go and I'm very excited to be doing this series. Go has recently become one of my favorite programming languages and I hope you guys are going to watch through this and see why it's so cool and how powerful the language actually is. So what I'm going to do right now is just give you a brief overview of what this tutorial series is going to look like, talk a little bit about Go as a language as a whole so you understand a bit more about it, and then get into actually setting up an environment to write Go code in, showing you how we can run a program and writing our first hello world. So this tutorial series is likely going to be between 20 and 25 videos long. I'm going to hopefully be posting them every day. It might be every other. We'll see depending on how much I get done. But the idea is to cover all of the aspects of the language. So we're going to start right from the beginning. We're going to talk about types. We're going to talk about variables, constants, all of that, and go all the way up until we get into some more advanced features like concurrency. I'll talk more about concurrency later, but the idea is that Go is actually built around speed and concurrency. And one of the coolest features of this language is how easy it is to create multiple threads and multiple processes in this Go language. So we'll talk about that. So that is pretty much what this series is going to look like. I hope you guys stick around. And again, yes, they'll be coming out probably every day, maybe every other day. If you want to see them before they go live, consider becoming a channel member, as that is one of the perks that I give early access to content that I've finished that's not yet live. Anyways, the Go programming language itself is actually an imperative programming language. So comparing it to something like Java or Python, which are considered object-oriented programming languages, and then we have some other paradigms like logical, functional, object-oriented, this is considered imperative. Now we'll talk more about that later and you'll see why it is imperative, but this was actually developed about 10 years ago by two ex-Google employees, or I believe it was actually developed at Google and they're ex-Google employees now. But they developed this language because they wanted to make one that was a combination of something like C++ and Java and a more modern language like Python. So they liked the syntax and style of a language like Python, but they wanted the speed and efficiency of a lower level language like C++, like C. And so you'll see that there's a lot of combinations and things that are taken from other languages in this language, which makes it much easier to learn if you've learned another programming language before. So Go is a great language. It's used a lot on the server side and the backend side of things. And a lot of people now are actually using this on the web because of how fast it is and the fact that we don't have to give up, you know, the speed to market because we can write this code a lot faster than we would be able to write something in C++ or Java per se. So that's a little bit about Go. That's a little bit about this series. And I hope you guys are ready now to jump in and get started. So what we're going to be doing for this series is actually using VS Code. VS Code stands for Visual Studio Code. It's developed and maintained by Microsoft, and it is probably one of the most popular IDEs and editors today. So it's great to learn how to use this and just start using it if you're not already. So the first thing we're going to need to do is actually download this. Now, if you have not already, go to visualstudio.com. I will leave this link in the description and download whatever build is for your system. So in my case, I'm using Windows, but this will work on Mac and Linux as well. And in fact, this whole tutorial series, there shouldn't be many differences on any of the OSs. All right, so once we download that, what we're going to do is head over to the Golang website. Again, all these links will be in the description and we're going to download Go. So we actually need a Go compiler. I believe it's called the compiler interpreter, whatever it is they're calling it, to run our Go code. So go ahead and select the one from the feature download sections that matches your operating system. In this case, I'm using Windows, but you can use Mac or Linux. And if you want an older version or the same version I'm using for this series, which is 1.14.2, shouldn't make a difference, by the way, then you can look at the exact versions and all of them down here. All right, so once we have Go and once we have a VS Code, we are ready to get set up. And in fact, one disclaimer here, once you start downloading Go, and I apologize if you already did this, please make sure you add Go to path. Now it should do this automatically, but I forget if there's a little checkbox or something you can select, but you do want this in your system path so that you can access it and we can use the Go command. So just try to make sure that that happens. If you're having issues with the path and getting Go to work with the commands that I'm using, then please do leave a comment and I'll try to respond to that. But yeah, so let's go ahead now and go to VS Code. So I've installed those. Now I'm going to actually open up VS Code. And I'm just doing that by hitting VS in this bar here. And I'm going to show you how we can get started in this IDE. Now, a lot of people get mad at me because I call this an IDE. I think it's pretty much an IDE, although it is officially considered a text editor. This is very popular, and I assume most of you probably already have this. Now, we have some options when we boot this up. So we can start a new file, which is, I guess, recommended somewhat, or we can open a folder. And what I'm going to recommend to you guys is to actually write this code alongside with me. And what I think you should do, and what I'm going to be doing, is let's make a folder on our desktop or somewhere that we want to access, and call that Golang or Go or whatever you want. So call it that, put it on your desktop, and that's where we should actually be using all our files for this tutorial series, or at least what I'll be doing. So once you've done that and you've made a folder, and that's where you're going to store all of the code that we write, we're actually going to go ahead and just open that folder from Visual Studio Code. So you should see that here. I'm in full screen mode, but if I exit out, you could go to File and then go Open Folder. That's another way to do that as well. So let's go ahead, Open Folder. I'm going to go and find Golang, which is a folder I've already created, and select Open. So we can see that it pops up a little bar on the left-hand side here. We can go ahead and close this welcome tab. And this is where we have some files. Now I've written a file here just for a future tutorial. Your folder will likely be empty, but the first thing we need to do if we want to write Go code is make a new Go file. So we're going to click new file and we're going to save and call this tutorial.go. Now notice when I put the extension.go in, it actually shows me the little gopher, which is the Golang icon on the left-hand side here, which is telling me that this is a Go file. If yours doesn't show that, don't worry, but just make sure it ends in .go. All right, so there we go. We actually have our first Go file. And in fact, you know, this is the first Go program pretty well, right? We need to add a few lines, obviously, but we're getting there. So what we're going to do now in VS Code is actually install what's known as the Go extension. Now, VS Code by default comes fairly lightweight, so it doesn't come with a ton of features and things installed. You add them on as you need them. So one of the extensions we need is Go. So let's go to this extension tab, which is on the left-hand side here, underneath the little debugger, which is the bug and the play, and click that, and then go ahead and search for Go. When we do that, we should see that Go, the official package from Microsoft, pops up. We need to install this. Now notice I already have this installed, but what you're likely going to need to do is just press install, give it a few seconds, it will install that, and now you will have a syntax highlighter, you'll have a little bit of a debugger. Actually, I don't know all of the things that come with it, but there's a bunch of things that will be added to VS Code to make your life a lot easier when you write Go code. So I'm going to exit out of that, and now I'm going to show you how we can actually write our first Go script and print out Hello World, which is obviously the goal for all these first tutorials, is, you know, get up and running and make sure everything that's working. So the first thing we need to do is actually define a package. So in all of our Go files, we need to make them inside of a package. So I'm going to say package main. Now this is just kind of the default, that we need to write this at the top of all of our files. I'll talk more about packages in future tutorials. For now, just whenever we're writing Go code, let's put package main. It'll just make your life a little bit easier, especially because we're not going to be dealing with a ton of different Go files and importing things between them. So let's go ahead and do package main. And now we're actually going to import a module called FMT. Now FMT is kind of a standard module. You're going to almost always import this in your Go code. What this allows you to do is actually print things out to the console. So display messages, display text, stuff like that. There's a few other things this does as well, but we're going to import FMT. And these are the first two lines that we should have in our file. Now, after we do that, we're actually going to define what's known as the entry point to our program. Now, this is a function. You may not know what functions are. You may not have seen them before. Don't worry about that. But just understand that what we need in our Go code, if we want this file to actually run, execute, and do something, is we need to define, and I'm in my Python syntax here, so we're going to write func main. We're going to do bracket, so an open bracket, a close bracket, and then we're going to open a curly brace like this and close the curly brace. Now inside of this function, this is what's known as our entry point. Now this means that this function will automatically run, it will be called, which we'll talk about in a second, when we build and run our Go program, or sorry, when we execute the Go program. So essentially anything inside of these squiggly brackets will happen when we run this Go code. Now inside of here, we can do kind of whatever we want. We'll learn more about that as we go through the videos, but just know that this is the entry point. And for our purposes right now, again, we'll talk about all the details later. We want to understand that what's in here is going to run when we run this specific file. So if we made another Go file, we would need to put a different main function inside of there. And then that means when we run that other file, whatever was inside of that other main function would run, right? That's the idea behind it. So we want to get to printing Hello World and getting something to work here. So what we're going to do is type fmt.println, And then inside of this statement here, we're actually going to type what we want to print. So the basic syntax here, and syntax is just another word for like the style, the way we write something. You can think of it as like grammar or punctuation, stuff like that in English, just the style and the format in which you write things in, is we're going to do FMT, which is this module that we've imported up here, dot println. What this tells our program to do is print a new line, so display a new line to the console, which we'll show in a second, that says whatever's inside of these quotation marks. So we need to make sure that this looks exactly like my code, but inside these quotation marks, we can put whatever we want. Now I'm going to put hello world, but mess around and put whatever else you want inside of here. And we have officially written our first Go or Golang program. Now, why do we need these quotation marks? I'm sure some of you will make the mistake and go ahead and do that. Well, that's for a reason that I can't fully disclose right now, because you don't have the knowledge if you're not a former programmer. But the idea is that we need a specific data type inside of here to print out. So whenever we want to print a string, that's what this is known as, we need to put it inside of quotation marks. And that will tell the program that, hey, we actually want to show this text. This text is something we want to display, or we want to use it as text. We don't want to use it as like func main, right? As syntax, ideally. That's kind of what I'm trying to get at. This will make more sense later, but whenever we print something, for now, just put it inside of double quotation marks, okay? Now, single quotation marks does not work. This is what we would use for actually a character. So if we put something inside of single quotation marks, we're pretty much saying this is a character, not a string, where a string is actually a collection of characters. So like if H is a character, then a string is a collection of a bunch of characters, right? That's the idea. Okay, so we've done that. So let's save our file by hitting Control S. I believe you could also go here and hit save. Is there something? Maybe not. Okay, so Control S, we'll save that. And now what I'm gonna do is show you how we can actually run and build this Go code. So what we need to do is actually open up a new terminal window. Now for some of you, you might, so we don't need to leave VS Code for this, although we can do it outside if we want. For some of you may not see this bottom window that I have, right? Maybe it's off the screen, maybe it disappeared. So what we're actually gonna do, and let me just pop this full screen, is go to View, and then we're gonna select Terminal here. Now the shortcut is Control plus whatever that character is, which is above the tilde, I believe, if you look on the keyboard, or maybe it's below the tilde on your keyboard, whatever it is, it's top left side above the tab key. That's what you do to toggle the terminal. That will pop this up down here if it's not already here, or it will make it go away if it already is there. And then what we're gonna do is, assuming if you see some text here and you can type, good. Otherwise, just hit this plus button, and then what it will do is make a new terminal window for you that you should be able to type in. Now, my VS Code's kind of going crazy here. Let me see if I can actually type something. Okay, so I can. But we need to get it to look something like this, and then we can actually start building our program. So by default, this will open a command prompt window or a terminal, depending on what operating system you're on, in the directory that you open. So we open the Golang folder. Notice that it says desktop Golang. That's where the folder is, which now means we can actually use the command go run tutorial.go to run our program and see the output. So this is a very simple program. It's only 7 lines of code. But what I told you is that this main function, whatever's inside of here, is going to run when we run this code. So let's have a look. We should be seeing hello world printing out. So I'll hit enter, give it a second, and hello world is displayed to the screen. So we have officially written our first Go program. Now, before I wrap it up, which will be shortly, I want to talk to you about how this works. So Go is actually, what is it called? A compiled language. Now, what that means is essentially before we can actually execute this code, we need to translate it into information that the computer can understand. So essentially take this, put it into what's called assembly language, or actually don't know what the language is for Go specifically, but some lower level language that is closer to what the computer can understand, so that when we actually run that compiled code, the computer knows what to do. Because the idea is that this here that we've written, the computer cannot directly understand. So we need to compile this and then pass that compiled file to the computer when we decide to run this. So what Go run does is it automatically compiles this for us, and then it goes ahead and runs that compiled file. Now, if we want to actually compile this beforehand, and maybe we don't want to run it right away, or we want to actually just take the manual steps, what we do is we type go build and then the name of the file, so tutorial.go. Now, just notice on the left-hand side of my screen that I don't have any other files, so I just have two. And when I hit this and I give it a second, we see that a tutorial.exe file actually pops up. So what that means is this is the kind of compiled file, the built file, if you want to call it that. And now we can actually run this exe like we would any other exe file. So we could double click on it. We can actually just type the name of the exe if we're on Windows, so tutorial.exe. If we're on Mac or Linux, we can type ./tutorial.exe and that will run it. But what's great about this is that I can take this file, I can send it to you, and it doesn't matter what operating system you're on, you'll be able to run it. And you don't actually have to have Go installed to run it, which is really nice as well. So that's the idea behind this. This has been the introduction and overview of Go. Hopefully all this is working and things have been set up for you. One quick thing to note, you may see some pop-ups in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. If you do and it says, would you like to install this? Go ahead and click yes. They're just some extensions and add-ons for when we're writing the Go code here. And it'll just make our lives a little bit easier, so you can go ahead and do that. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next tutorial.